Hey everyone, Michael here. So if you're a Lucifer fan like me, you probably know that this has recently been issued, the Luke 3, Steve Lukather's signature Music Man guitar. That's my own Black Sparkle Luke 2 with the EMG pickups. Now the few changes on the newer one, let's just take a look from top to bottom. This particular one has a solid rosewood neck. It's pretty tasty. If I just roll it over, you can see the, this is a gunstock oiled neck. So there's no finish on this neck. It's just been, you know, it's got gunstock oil on it. But where it's been finished, you can see the depth of the, it's just a lovely piece of rosewood. It's, I mean, it looks very, very pretty. Locking machine heads. Little change there, it just now says L3, which is pretty cool, instead of Luke. Headstock's pretty much the same. Okay, the actual setup of the guitar is the same as he has it, which is two springs. If I just take a look at the back here, it's two springs there, under tension, floating, so there's a nice pull up on the G string. Steve and I, we had an interview. I did an interview with him, and he handed me his guitar. So I had a good chance to fully check out his guitar, set up the amp for him, and just checked it was in tune before we did rolling. He went off to get something. He needed something to eat. So, but it was curious that he has it set exactly the same as I have my guitars set. Sort of two springs, plenty of float on the trem. The trems on these are just amazing. They work really, really well. Two post. The big significant change for the Luke 3 is the pickups and the size of the body. The body is 3% bigger than the Luke 2. When I spoke to Steve about it, he said, well, for tall people, it just looks better, bigger body. It's true, really. And I don't know if a little bit of a bigger body adds to the sound, but probably on taller people, these guitars did look a bit small. So nice improvement aesthetically. Big change is the pickups. So since 1984, 85, Steve Lukather's been using EMG pickups. I'm a big user of EMG pickups. For this Luke 3, he's opted for passive Damasios, and they do sound fantastic, although they have got a bit of a trick up their sleeve. The guitar has a 12 dB boost, which is on a push-pull pot just here. So for instance, if I go to this neck picker, you can see, if I just turn it down, can you hear that? There's a boost in there, 12 dB. Which means that these lovely single coil pickups can have extra, you know, extra grunt with the boost. These full-on sort of single coil sounds. There's two versions of this guitar. You got the two humbucker version, and this one is the I'm glad we got this one because I wanted to check it out myself. The humbucker and two single coil version, and the sounds are pretty sweet with these pickups. That's the neck pickup. This here's the in between. Here's the mid pickup. Here's the in-between. And here's the humbucker. You know, that is a different sound to what the EMG one has, the older one. It's a more focused sound. These pickups are custom designed by Music Man, and they're Damasio derived. They do sound fantastic, very organic sounding. The guitar comes with 9s to 42 strings as standard, which makes string bending very, very easy. The frets are lovely. I mean, Music Man guitars, you could buy a Music Man guitar without even, you know, trying it, because I've never really picked up a bad Music Man guitar, and I've played a lot of Ernie Ball Music Man guitars, and they come, you know, they take real pride in the manufacture of them. You know, it's as good as it can really get. The color, what do you think on the color? This is called olive gold. Apparently these guitars come in two colors, black and this one, olive gold. It's sort of, I don't know, it's sort of got a bit of a green in there and a bit of a gold in there. It's certainly a look. The one that Steve had was sort of a silvery grey-y colour with the two humbuckers. But apparently, as standard, they come in black and this olive gold. 25.5-inch radius. The weight of it, they're going for £7, 8 ounces, around about, you know, £7, 7.5 pounds. It's a lovely, you know, fairly light guitar. This is order, the wood is order, and the combination of the order and the rosewood really works. The one that Steve had was obviously, I checked it out, he had a maple neck with a rosewood board, and the neck had a real sort of serious flame on it. So, but you know, I'm sure they're gonna do that one as well. Because they're passive pickups, I guess it has to be screened quite thoroughly. I mean, with EMG pickups, you can just put them in a guitar and it's going to be dead silent. But for, you know, for under lights and in studios in front of computers, you need the guitar screened. And this is dead quiet for a passive loaded guitar. But they've screened the cavities with apparently something called electronic graphite acrylic resin, which is screening it all. And underneath the cavities, apparently we've got aluminium covering these pieces of plastic. There's the battery. The battery isn't for the pickups. It's obviously for this boost. And this boost is transparent. You can't feel it at all, even on the real sort of, as I back down the volume, in some boosts you can really sort of hear that there's something going on, but this is just dead transparent. Acoustically, the guitar just rings. It's got all the tones you need, really. It's just a fantastic tonal guitar. I always say this with signature guitars, you know, even though it's a signature guitar for Steve Lukather, you know, if you just take that out of the equation, in itself, it's a great guitar. You know, it will cover all areas really, really well. It's a great rock guitar, great funk guitar. You can get any sort of tones out of it. The pickups sound great. It plays great straight out of the box. It stays in tune, and I've been really giving it some grief with the whammy bar when we were filming and warming up, and it's still dead in tune, which is really nice. So I haven't got a bad thing to say about it. I have got a bad thing to say about it. I'm not a fan of this olive gold. But I'm sure they're going to do some real cooler colours in my book. You might love it. That's cool. It does have a look. It's very modern looking. I still like my old black sparkle finish. This was a real rare finish they did. Apparently, back in the early 2000s, it was a real nightmare colour to get done. Steve Lukather has two of these black sparkles. You can often see his guitars often come with the Fernandez Sustainer pickup. It'd be nice. I wonder if they do one of those. A lot of these, the black sparkle one he uses and the red one he uses has a Sustainer pickup just there. So he gets some real cool singing sustain. Be interesting to see if they do a version like that. So The Luke 3, I haven't got a bad word to say about it. You know, I might grow to like the colour. it's pretty cool. I mean, it is cool. It is a cool colour. And anything that makes you think, you know, is gonna, if you get a reaction out of a colour, then it's gotta be a good colour, you know. Pickups sound great, whammy bar's great, neck feels awesome, stays in tune. You know, what more could you possibly want from a guitar? Ernie Ball, Music Man, Luke 3, real great guitar. Try it out when you see one.